It's known during talking that the tidal volume, the size of each breath, increases, and so does the respiratory rate. So that's why people who talk for a living, they are at a bit of a disadvantage. They'll tend to be more tired. They'll find that at the end of a day they're exhausted. They don't necessarily put it down to their talking. They think it's because of the mental stimulation. No, talking is very demanding on the human being. Physically, our breathing should increase if there's an increase of metabolic activity. If we increase our metabolism, we generate more carbon dioxide. If we generate more carbon dioxide, then breathing can increase because it's fine, because the physical exercise has generated more CO2, which has stimulated breathing. But during talking, we're standing still. Or worse, you could be sitting down at a desk. How many of you here talk for a living? It's really, would you agree, you know, it is demanding. It's demanding. Nobody trains school teachers. Nobody looks at how people in sales are breathing.
Yes.
I'm very conscious of my breathing. I did exercise before I start today, yes. I did meditation as well for a time this morning. Usually we get into 20 minutes, depending on the drillers downstairs. We get 20 minutes in. My mouth was taped last night. I've been taping up for 20 years. I've brought it into my way of life. My main rule with talking is not to hear my breathing. That's my main rule. But I always try and bring a feeling of relaxation throughout my body as well. And if my body is relaxed, my breathing tends to be relaxed.
And if you do teach classes?
Yes.
So you're exercising or walking around a lot while
teaching? A little bit, but you're not really, you know, in comparison. I'll still feel the effects, you know, but in terms of what would it have been like 20 years ago, I would have been floored. So you're still well able to deal with it, but of course you'll feel the effects of it, yes.
You said that in the book, I think you said during the breaks you do something like the breathe light exercise, right?
Yes, I tend to, like, I'll always try to fit it in. I don't do the exercises formally, but I'll do them a little bit here, there. I go back in a long haul flight, I'll allow my breathing to reduce. If I'm driving my car, my breathing reduces. I like the whole aspect of relaxation throughout the day, that even if I'm talking here, I bring my attention throughout the body, that I'm not just stuck in my head, and allow the breath to relax. So I try and bring it in. Nobody is going to continue with these exercises indefinitely. Nobody. So what we want to do is we want to kind of show you, if you breathe hard, your blood vessels constrict. If you have your mouth open, it's going to cause breathing abnormalities. So we want to try and change your everyday breathing so it makes it for your life.
Have you seen a vocal coach?
Pardon?
A vocal coach.
Have I seen one?
Yeah.
No. I've never had an issue with it. Now, in terms of, we've had professional singers coming in who were losing their voices during the winter. And the one thing that I got them to do was put paper tape in their mouth. The ones that would do the exercises, yes, great. But some of them wouldn't do the exercise, wore the paper tape. Because if you think of it, there's 6 to 8 hours that these individuals had their mouth open. And their airways are traumatized. Their throat, their larynx is traumatized. You know, you wake up with a dry mouth in the morning, that's trauma. The whole upper airway is inflamed. So we get the mouth closed.